Okay, hi, I'm Jonathan. I'm from the DWG, or University of Göttingen. And I've kind of hidden the container topics in this one because it's only later on getting towards containers. But still, I think this is part of a project we had started this year, and it has been very quickly adopted by our users about a Slurm-based LLM chat service. So connecting HPC resources with making it a service, despite all the limitations that our security guys put on it. But let's get into it first. Put this thing away. Okay, so a short bit of advertisement for our Qiskey project, which is a national effort in Germany, financed by public money, about building AI service centers, so supporting researchers and small companies, startups with AI resources, so that they can get moving and build up Germany as an AI place. And they also paid for a cluster for us, so it's great for me personally because I like having a big cluster with lots of GPUs to do stuff like this project I'm about to talk about. So what we want to do is we want to create an LLM chat service for open source models, and users should be able to log in from our single sign-on and send up prompts, and these should all be private. So that's our distinction feature compared to like ChatGPT and Gemini and so on. We don't store any user data, and there are still people out there who care about this. Like, according to our statistics, only 30% of users, but more about that later. So, but we have now deployed Slurm, our GPU cluster. So how do we turn this into a service? We have also further limitations. We are only allowed to use SSH for external access, and the admins do not allow automatic login on command execution. But there's a little star, because there's an exception to that rule that we found. There's also the problem of non-exclusive access, so this cluster should be used by other users for other stuff. So we can't just take it all down and run something else than Slurm, because other users are already using Slurm for it. We also have cloud VMs available, but they don't have GPUs, and performance of anything that's bigger than a 7 billion parameter model on a cloud VM, even the 7 billion parameter models already suck on a VM without GPUs. So we have to use some GPUs resources for the inference part. So short excursion about why I consider this problematic. If you think about batch jobs and service jobs, so a batch job is like the classic HPC part. So we can submit a job, it runs at some point, it needs all the resources at once. For example, if you still in the machine learning context, it's a machine learning training, and you would do something like Slurm, and you can use containers. With the server side, the system expects to run its jobs immediately. You can have a subset of the resources that you're using, like your EVM operation, if you run 2 out of 10 replicas of a service, for example, and it's more used for inference, and we'll commonly use something like Kubernetes for it. And it's almost always like most platforms that do this stuff use containers. So anyway, we use Slurm for this stuff instead of Kubernetes because, as I mentioned earlier, we have these limitations. This is where our project comes in. So first up, we need to solve the threaded user login. So this was relatively easy. We just put an Apache web server in front of it who does SSO integration. It works surprisingly well. Like, I didn't think it would work that well. So then the other part was we are not allowed to do automatic SSH login. So there was this asterisk to it. What the security guys actually meant was that we are not allowed to provide and create a backdoor in case our front end gets hacked, that someone could get access to the cluster through it. What we were allowed to do was to set up a force command SSH, which limits an SSH key to only run a single command on a cluster. And that was allowed, actually, by security guys. So we were able to move ahead with this. I set up a sort of tunnel that forwards all our front end requests to the back end. Then we need to fix somehow that Slurm jobs are well limited in terms of runtime, and that we do not have permanent, like we can't make just jobs run 3 days every time then refresh it, because then we would be blocking these nodes for way too long. So we need to keep these jobs runtimes short, having some sort of scheduler that updates the routing tables depending on how many backend jobs we have.
Jonathan, talking about short.
Oh, sorry. Okay. So we have this architecture here. And to keep it short, this is what I'm talking about. We have the backend in the bottom, the cloud part in the middle is using also an API gateway, and it works quite well. If you have more questions, I have more slides on this thing. I'm looking forward to discussing whether you also have this request about LLM service and based on your GPU resources.
And yeah, but all it's pre-working quite well. It has some limitations in terms of startup times and having to do it manually. It does use some containerization in the cloud when we want to move it to a Kubernetes platform at some point. And for some funny reason, our Slurm controller is containerized in Kubernetes cluster because our admin thought would be interesting to see if it improves reliability. With that, the thing runs right now for about 3,000 requests per day with increasing usage numbers since we enabled API support. And we still see high interest from various companies into private LLMs with open source support. And it's available as a Kiski service, so if you join up, you can use it today. And yeah, thank you very much.